Hello friends, now we'll see the call flow. How you synchronize. So we'll see in log what happens, how things is look like, whatever I have seen, UE after UE switch on, say UE scan the frequency, UE search the cell, UE read the cell, it's synchronized with the DC subcarrier. After that, it's read primary synchronization, secondary synchronization. After that, it's read physical cell ID. In physical cell ID, it decode the references signal, it's decode the MEEB. After that, it's decode the SIEB. And after that, I have seen that it's a process to first it's scanned all the RSI frequency. After that, it's check for the threshold value, and once its threshold value crossed, then it's the decode the PCPICS decoding and PSA decoding, and some decoding successful, some decodings failure, then successful decoding, it make a list of the successful decoding. After that, just particular 3 to 4 cell as there, then it's the read it decode the all the these 4 cells, and you decode the MEEB for each and every candidate with the procedure. Now you can make list of the frequency, physical cell ID and PLMN, and that based on this information and based on and make a list of these all the things, and based on the UE SIM information, UE SIM stored information, can figure out which cell is the real candidate cell to camp on, and try to decoding the system information and proceed to registration procedure and complete the registration. And now here, after the SIP decoding, it will go for the registration procedure, and RATCH and RAR will and call flow will started. So before that, just I want to show whatever we have seen these all the things, just I want to show the call at the log, these all the things look like in log. So this is the log of the basic things, from the power on, and it's the search the frequency. After that, it's the get a camp on the one particular cells. After that's decode the MEEB and SIP. So how it look like, so just you can see here, there is a release 9, and it's the get a LT slab, and wake up. This is the wake up time, but that means you power on. After that, some configuration is happened here. After the scan the frequency, there is a frequency range 6173 to 6427, and cross carrier frequency, and start frequency 6173, actually its range is 6173 to 6427. Now start EFCN 6173, and EFCN is 16 best 3, total 3 is best between this 6173 and 6427. Total EFCN is 60 and 3 is best in 16, and start EFCN is 6413, and here is total you have seen is 15 and best 3 6422 and 6413. So this is the best 3. After that, its range is 23 to 577, you have seen range, and start you have seen from 23. This is the 23, it's try to scan from 23. There is total you have seen is 60 and 3 is the best, and 567 it will check. Check the all the EFCN between 23 to 567. Start EFCN 567 and 3 is the best. So after that, between the this one, it's scan the all the frequency, and it's report the RSSI. Just see here, EFCN is here 2200 10999, 3 EFCN is now its get, and report RSSI for the every, it's report the RSSI value for the every EFCN. And after that, it's select which one is the best EFCN, which RSI value is good. So it's EFCN 900 is there, and it's now its cell scan request will send, cell scans network will send the cell scan indicator EFCN and physical cell ID, RSRP, RSRQ, these all the value will send network. After that, UE start MEEB indicator said to decode the MEEB, it send the MEEB indicator, And for this one, it's know that 20 megahertz bandwidth, physical satellite is zero. These all the information I get from MIB indicator. A master information MIB indicator is started. After that, it's read the SIV, decode the SIV, reference signals, decode the SIV information, and from here decode the SIV, and it get the all the information whatever is required for the uplink synchronization. Yes, you can see SI read and system information block, BCH, SIB, paging cycles, and maximum transmission power 900 is finally camp on, and after camp on 900 priority 4, and now here it will send the RRC connection request. Ratch is happened here in middle of this one. After this, RRC connection request is sent. So this is the call flow of how you scan all the frequency, how you select the real candidate cells. So this is the overall picture of what happens after power on, UE power on. So thanks for watching this video. Bye, take care, good night.